saa vierailta Venäjältä. Molemmat joukkueet tällä hetkellä saavat molempien voitto rekordi voittoja 1-2. Tämän kentällä oikeutta jakavat patronit valkoisessa kirkkalatissaan Kalle Kivimaa, aputuomari Lauri Lampinen, rajatuomari Jyve Valtteri Klinter, linjatuomari Petra Elohanta sekä ratatuomari Jan Riian. Tervetuloa tervetulleeksi kentälle Sam Pirko Valkoviinas. Pietari kuoltaa tänään aloituskokoonpanosta, jossa takakentän pelaajana on 25.
Hello to all viewers and welcome to this international stream of a ladies Maple League, Finnish highest level of women's football. One of the best leagues in whole Europe, of course. Finland is the reigning European champion. Our international guest in Finnish league is St. Petersburg Valkyries. They played their first season with the Finnish league already last year. Last year they managed to get one win, but this year they have proven to be much better team, and they already have 3 wins and 1 loss before this game, and they are tightly fighting for the playoff spot this year, so they have improved a lot from last year. Today Valkyries are facing the reigning Finnish champions, Demons from Helsinki. One of the as Valkyries head coach Ilya Kravchov told me before the game, they are really excited to play Demons, because Demons is, if not the best, at least one of the best and most successful franchises in women football in whole Europe. They have won most Finnish championships, Helsinki Roosters being the next most successful team in Finland in history of women's football. This game promises to be really exciting and tight one, because both teams have a record of 3-1 and have lost only one game. They have played quite a few same teams, so they are pretty close to each other. The difference being that Demons only lost game against Roosters, which is the unbeaten team this year. St. Petersburg Valkyries, the only loss they suffered this year was against Seinäjoki Crocodiles, the team that Demons beat narrowly 0-6. So that shows that these two teams are pretty close together. And at the moment they are third and fourth place in Maple League. Valkyrie is having the upper hand because they have a little bit better goal difference. But of course, after this game, when winner goes to the third place and takes a tight grip for the playoff spot. As I said, Valkyries and Demons are sharing the third and fourth place at this time. Roosters, the other team from Helsinki, are at the top of the league with the draw chance from Turku being the next team. Valkyries still have to face both of those teams, so they have a really, really tight schedule in the end of the season. Of course, this has helped them a lot during the first part of the season. They have mostly played a little bit weaker teams, but I think that this has been really good for them, because they have been able to show their improvement and gain really, really good confidence towards the end of the season. when having talks with head coach Kravtsov of Valkyrie's team, in addition to being really compliment towards Demon's team, I asked which are he thinks that are the keys to this game, and he told that he sees the matchup against the Demon's offense versus their defense the really key to this game. He pointed out that Demons have lost a couple of key players from last season from the offensive side football, especially the best European quarterback in the women's leagues, Jenny Wahlberg, is out because of the injury. And also they have lost some of their key players on defense, so he was anxious to see how that matchup goes. Both of these teams are really based on run-first offenses, but they are able to pass still, but rely first on the run. Demons may be a little bit more passing offense, and especially like to throw some short passes mixed with the run. Valkyries, on the other hand, are option-based offense on offensive side of football. They run regular spread set mixed up with some zone read option and also some traditional pitch option plays. And when they throw, they are going more to deep maybe than Demons. So that's an interesting point also to see if that holds true to this game. And now Valkyries are starting the game with the kickoffs, and we're gonna probably see Demons offense on the field first after this kickoff return. Demons returner Anu Ruotsalainen, number 85, is ready to take the kickoff. She catches the ball on 30-yard line. Really good return, really good blocks. He goes almost untouched over the half line. Fumbles in the end, but there's no Valkyries close to the ball. And I think that the referee has already whistled her down before the fumble. So, Tiina Möttönen, number 12, quarterback for Demons this year, takes her offense to the field at Valkyries' 48-yard line. First and 10. Demons come out with the one back set with two tight ends on their right side. And this is something we're going to probably see from both offenses a lot. Quarterbacks also run the ball themselves. Both of the quarterbacks are good athletes. But an excellent tackle from Valkyries. They tackle the quarterback for a two-yard tackle for loss, but seems that there might be a flag on the play. It's a face mask for Valkyries, or it was a personal foul, so it's 15 yards and a first down. The referee didn't show if it was a face mask or horse collar, but nonetheless, 15 yards. So, Demon's offense moves to the 35-yard line of Valkyries. First and then again. Now a run from two back set, but really good defense again from Valkyries. Valkyries play really aggressive 3-3-4 defense, splits a lot, and they're able almost to make a tackle for loss again, but Ruotsalainen evades the first tackler's foot B and runs for a one-yard gain. Second and 9. And the same almost repeats itself on the right side. Number 55 from Valkyrie's defense, Anna Badievia, comes through the line, but is not able to make the tackle for loss. Ruotsalainen gains 1 yard, but Valkyries defensive front is doing really, really good job to start this game. It's a 3rd and 8. It's probably a passing down for Demons, maybe out of the play action. Problems with the snap, and quarterback gets buried immediately. Numbers 25 and 63 from Valkyrie's defense are there immediately. And it's a 4th and 17. Some problems with the chain. But doesn't matter that much. It's 4th and 22 actually. Demons elect to play, but Valkyrie's defense is there again. Number 63 making again a good play, Valeria Krutikova. Sorry for all the Russian listeners about the pronunciations of Russian names. I'll do my best during the stream. So, excellent play from Valkyrie's defense. They gave the first down only on a penalty, which wasn't that bad, but of course all the penalties will be taken away by referees. But no gain for Demon's offense after that. Valkyrie's offense is on the field, led by quarterback number 9, Lubyov Lukina. Run to the middle, 2-yard gain. Number 33, Anna Liuter, was carrying the ball. She's one of the running backs with a really good rush offense of Valkyries. Trips to the right side and option to the left. Demons do a really good job on defending that. Quarterback takes a big hit and is forced to pitch the ball. And after that, Ruotsalainen, who was carrying the ball on the offense, makes the tackle on defense as an outside linebacker. It's a 3rd and 8. Or even closer to 3rd and 9, so a small loss for that play. Valkyries go empty, and it's a passing down. Looks a little bit like a false start on the offense. Good catch for the short gain, but Demons are able to make the tackle before the first down. It's Valkyrie's 4th and maybe a little bit over 1, and they are going for it. They're over the half field already. They go empty again, but as I said, the quarterback can run by herself too, so this might be a run play also. A quick pass for number four, towards number 14, but it's incomplete, so the Demons' offense is back on the field. Both defenses have started really well. We hear Demons' head coach, Mikaela Ranta, giving pointers to her O-line that now you have to block a little bit harder. The first series was dominated by Valkyrie's defensive front, especially D-line and blitzing linebackers were coming through quite hard. Number 63 is there again. That was a third big play out from 63. Valeria Krutikova already, she has had a really, really great start for this game. It's a 5-yard loss and 2nd and 15. This promises to be a tight game with both defenses playing really tight. Some room for Ruotsalainen, but only a 4-yard gain, so no worries for Valkyries. It's a 3rd and 11. We might see quarterback Möttönen to come out in a boot again, maybe with a run-pass option on the edge. It's a straight drop back, quick pass. Short catch, but really good run after the catch. We get really close to the first down. I think it's maybe two yards to go on the 4th, and Demons are definitely going for it in this field position already. it will be a key for the Valkyries defense to tackle those short passes fast. Ruotsalainen comes in for the run play, but the Valkyries defense is there again. Number 89 makes the tackle for loss. Darja Briučovetskaja. Hope I really got that even close. So, neither defense have given first downs for the opposing offense except for the penalty for Valkyries on the first play of the, from the scrimmage. But after that, no first downs on either offense. Quick bubble pass to receiver number 88. And again, a key for Demons defense also, they need to make the tackles on short passes. First down for either offense. Valkyries take the first and 10 from Demons 43-yard line. Seems that both defenses are really tight against the run, so probably the short passes will play a big role in this game. Same play to the other side, but now one of the best and the most experienced safeties in Europe, all-star safety from World Championships and European Championship games, Anette Bäckman, number 44 from Demons, makes the tackle for the loss. So the defense that is able to prevent the yards after the catch is really going to be strong in this game. It's an empty again, but quarterback calls the running back next to her. Runs a little play action, then there's a fumble, but number 14 from Valkyries covers the ball. And a little bit lucky bounce for Valkyries on that play. It's a third and 5, or maybe 6. Third and 6 from 39-yard line. It's going to be really hard to earn yards in this game. Both defenses have started really well. Empty set, quarterback calls the running back back to the backfield again. Quick pass for the running back. This will be a hard call for the referees. I'd say it was forward pass, but referees are showing a lateral pass at least to start the game. So we'll see. There is a small injury, hopefully only a small injury, but to Katri Laine, number 13 of Demons. She's able to walk out by herself. So both defenses playing really hard. So first and 10 for Demons from their own 43-yard line. Seems that Katri Laine is okay. She'll probably be back in the game soon. She is one of the most experienced players on Demon's side, and they're going to really need it. Now the Demon's offensive line shows really excellent blocking. And Ruotsalainen is able to cut back to the backside with 9-yard gain immediately. If Demons get their run offense working this well, it will be a much harder day for Valkyries defense, which has started out really well. Valkyries defense toughens up, but because it was second and 1 already, Ruotsalainen is able to take the first down with a 1.5, maybe 2-yard gain. Injury to Valkyries player 63, Valeria Krutikova, whose name we've already said many times in this game. So hopefully the injury is not bad and she's able to make it back, because she had a really great start to the game. First and 10 for Demons from 46-yard line of Valkyries. No. it's a counter play, but Valkyrie's defense is there on the backfield already, number 79 and number 25. 79 is Veronika Jatsina. Made an excellent play on a counter play, down blocks didn't really hold up, so a tackle for a loss again. Second and 14 from the half field. Möttönen passes after the play action. The ball bounces out of the hands of Elina Kerran, number 41, tight end for Demons team. And the defensive coordinator, she has a role of a player coach this year. Elina is a really experienced linebacker, has played for Demons many years and has won several Finnish championships with them, and also has been a key part and captain of national team for a long time. Möttönen passes again, and this time it's a quick pass. Katri Laine is back on the field and shows what she can do the best. Looks like she's going all the way, almost. She gets tackled inside the 5-yard line. This is one of the strong suits of Katri Laine. She's a really powerful runner. When she gets going on the open field, it's really hard for any defense in Europe to catch her. Well, maybe they're able to catch her, but not tackle after that. She's that powerful runner. So it's first and goal from 5-yard line. So Demons offense has got it rolling. They have been able to mix it up a little bit, have been able to take some gains. Ruotsalainen France runs through the middle. Demons offensive line are obviously starting to get their blocks holding better. 3-yard gain from the middle, second and goal from 2-yard line. Run from the middle again. Ruotsalainen bounces back to the left side and is able to walk in. So Valkyrie's defense started out the game really, really well. Were able to make several tackles for losses. Were pressuring the ball carrier immediately after the handoff. But on this drive, Demons offense started to get their blocks where they're supposed to be, and thanks to the big gain for Katri Laine out of the swing pass from running back positions, Demons were able to walk through the whole field and are playing the 2-point conversion at the moment. Pass for Elina Kero. She's wide open, and this time she doesn't drop the ball. She catches it, secures it easily, and it's 8-0 to Demons. This was a really good drive from Demons. As I said, they were able to mix it up a little bit. Passes mixed up with a couple of good runs from Ruotsalainen, and offensive line started to get it together. And if this continues, I think that Valkyries are in a little bit of a trouble, because Demons have the best scoring defense in the Maple League at the moment. They have only allowed 22 points during the season, and all of that came against Roosters in the first game. So after that, they have shut out three next offenses. We'll see if Valkyries are able to score on them at all. But one thing will be sure: they are not going to score that many touchdowns. So Valkyries' defense really needs to get back to play the way they started the game. Yeah. huge hit from the short short kick. Demons are missing their regular kicker, so Jenni Kangas, number 16, took the kick off. The kick was pretty short, but a huge hit. I think it was number 55, Venla Nikula, if I saw correctly. You probably heard that in your living room too. Valkyries offense back to the field, first and 10 from their own 47-yard line. Valkyries change up their offensive formation. They have two running backs. Motion comes through the formation to the other side. It's a pass. Quick pass to the weak side. Referee shows that it's a catch just before the sideline. Number 14 is able to get her feet in. 4-yard gain. Good play for Valkyries to start the drive. It's a second and 6. Quarterback Lukina had no pressure at all on that play, so easy job for her to find the receiver. It's a run play. Number 89 is able first to cut back to the weak side, but Demons offense forces her to run laterally, so it's only a 1-yard gain. It almost showed up as she's going to be able to break it, but not this time. Demons defense did a really good job on the cutback. Two-back set, still strength to the right side. Play action pass. Oh, and the receiver was open, not wide open, but open enough. Linebacker wasn't able to get there in the coverage in time, but pass just out, fell ground before her outstretched arm. So it's 4th and 5 for Valkyries. They're still playing. We haven't seen any punts in this game. It's a play action pass. Number 14 is open again, but pass is too short for her, falls to the ground before her, and Demons offense comes back to the field. As we can see, neither team are really willing to punt around the half line, so we're gonna probably see a lot of those key fourth downs in this game. It's a Demons offense, first and 10, almost on the half line. Demons continue with their one back set. Offensive coordinator Petteri Salovalta yells for the Möttönen to pass to number 44, which she does, but she's maybe just a tad too late with the pass. It's a little bit short, but seems that there is a flag on the field. It will be probably pass interference against Valkyries. It's almost a little bit bad luck up for the Valkyries, because that penalty wasn't really necessary, because the safety was coming up really well for the ball. And I think that the pass interference came for the corner, but she wouldn't have needed to take it. But it's a 50-yard penalty. First and 10 from a 38-yard line for Demons. Valkyries, a 38-yard line. Demons offense on the roll again. It's Katri Laine with the ball. Is able to stiff arm the first tackler. 6-7 yards gain. It's a 7-yard gain. 2nd and 3. So Demons offense looks to continue where they ended with the last drive, so they're really getting it on the roll. Key is that Demons offensive line wasn't able to find the blitzing linebackers and D-line on first couple of drives, but now they've been doing a great job on blocking those. The front 7. Möttönen has time. Short pass to Elina Kero, just a little bit off target, and Kero is not able to make the diving catch. Third and three. This is, of course, a two-down territory for the Demons again, so Valkyries need two stops if they want the ball back. Demons come out with a one-back set with Katri Laine next to Möttönen. It's Laine runs a short swing, but Elina Kero is able to get open in the deep in a corner route, and Möttönen throws a perfect pass. It was a really good coverage from Valkyrie's side, but the ball was so well placed outside that Kero is able to make a great catch. So it's first and goal again for Demons, and the Valkyrie's defense is a little bit gassed out at the moment, it seems. A couple of players are leaning, and I think that forward, and I think that they are starting to get a little bit tired of the Demons' quick-paced offense. Möttönen's pass to number 39. She's not able to make the play on the ball. It was a decent pass, but 39 wasn't able to reach out. Heta Rantanen just missed the catch. Timeout for Valkyries. So their coach noticed the same thing that I was looking, that their players might be get a little bit tired. Demons offense works on a really, really fast pace. It's almost semi-no huddle offense. Their lineup on most plays without the huddle. Sometimes they stay in the huddle for a short time. But they're doing a really good job mixing it up at the moment. We haven't really seen that many Valkyries players on the backfield of Demons offense for a couple of drives, and that's been the key factor for Demons offense. They have excellent running backs. Ruotsalainen is a little bit smaller, quick back, and Katri Laine a little bit bigger, really powerful runner. So, and now their third back. No, it's Katri Laine still as a running back. So they can really mix it up with their running backs. Ball is given to Katri Laine, but this time Valkyrie's defense after the timeout, they come out really, really tough. It's only a 1 yard gain. Third and goal from a 4 yard line. This would be an excellent stop for Valkyries if they would be able to stop this, and it seems that it's the first quarter already. As we haven't seen any punts, the play has been pretty fast, and the first quarter goes in 24 minutes. During this quick break, we can go through a little bit of the statistics. Valkyrie's offense is the third scoring offense in the league after Trojans and Roosters. And Demons' scoring defense, as mentioned before, is the first. So there's a good matchup for those. Also, Demons' scoring offense is the fourth in the league, and Valkyrie's scoring defense is third in the league. So, of course, because it's the third and fourth place teams, we can assume that they are really tight on offense and defense also. But as we can see, they're doing really well on both sides of the ball in the league at the moment. In these games, Demons is having the upper hand at the moment. Valkyries have been able to move the ball with a couple of plays, but mostly they've been really tight earned yards. Demons have had a couple of big plays of them their own. Möttönen sprints out to the right side after a bootleg, but excellent play from number 80. She was fooled a little bit on the boot fact fake first, but she's able to run Möttönen from behind is Yelena Broskurikova. Excellent play from the defense and a 1 yard loss. Fourth and goal from 5 yard line. As I said, this would be great for Valkyries if they'd be able to stop this drive on the red zone. It's a quick slant for Johanna Pudas. She makes a contested catch. Defense was all over her, but excellent tight ball from Möttönen, and Pudas is just able to take the catch inside the goal line. It's an extra point, and Demons are gonna play it for a 2 point conversion. Quick pass to tight end number 22. She was able to slip out. Annukka Savirinne, she was quite open, but Möttönen misses her barely. So it's 14 to nothing at the moment. Seems that both teams don't have that many substitute players, but at the moment the Demons are looking fresher because of their fast-paced offense. They're able to keep Valkyries on their heels and are the team in the lead at the moment. Valkyrie's offense really needs to get something going on this drive, because if they need to put their defense back on the field immediately, it will be really hard for them. They need at least one or two first downs, and of course preferably many more. Jenny Kangas kicks the ball. It's a short bouncing ball. Number 67 takes it, but it's a hard hit again. Even though that the kicks aren't that that long, they're not really Valkyries aren't really not able to return them for that long gain either. But they have a good field position after that short return. First and 10 on their own 45 yard line. Trips to the right side. It's a pass play. Almost an interception by Anette Beckman, number 44. I was a little bit quick pass to the coverage. Lukina didn't have any pressure, so maybe she should have watched that a little bit more carefully. It's a second and 10. Seems that Valkyries are thinking that they haven't been able to run the ball enough and are starting to pass a little bit more. It's a good pass from Lukina, but the receiver drops the ball. It would have been just short of the first down, but would have been third and one. Now it's third and 10. So maybe, just maybe, Valkyrie should have stuck to the run game a little bit more. But it's of course easy to say from the commentator booth what you should do on the field. It's a third pass. It's a screen pass. But Niina Perttunen, experienced D-line man from Demons, is not fooled by the screen pass, and she's able to tackle it for a 1 yard gain. It's a fourth and eight, and there's somebody thinking on the Demon side that this might be the punt, and so it seems. But the quarterback is the punter also, so there's probably a big chance for a fake punt. There's a flag on the field, so this is almost a sort of a free play. The returner touched the ball, and the referee show it's a ball for Valkyries, but they're still on flag on the field, and I think that's an illegal formation from Valkyries. That would take it all the way back, but we'll see what the flag is. But the returner, Anette Beckman, made a small mistake. The ball touched her, and after that, the rest of the Demons team weren't sure that it touched the returner already. Now they're taking the flag away. There weren't any flag on the field, so it's Valkyrie's ball. Their biggest play this far, they were able to cover the muffed punt by Beckman. First and 10 for Valkyries on 28-yard line of Demons. Valkyries come out in a two-back set. It's a run. Now they're able to use almost the same type of a play that Ruotsalainen has been able to exploit a couple of times. The run starts to the left and cuts back to the right side. It's a nice 4 yard gain for the first down, so it's second and 6. Valkyrie's coaches heard what I said and started to get back to the run. It's an option. Quarterback really should have kept it herself, or at least the pitch back should be wider, much wider. There was a fumbled pitch, and that probably wasn't how it was supposed to be. The pitch back should be wider, but I think that Lukina should have run that herself. Valkyries get a little bit lucky, and Demon's sideline are also yelling out that it was a forward pass. Referees decided that it was a fumble forward, which is a little bit odd call, but referees make the calls on the field. Demons defense shows up really, really tough. And third and 1.5, they allow only for a half yard gain, so it's 4th and 1. Really key down for Valkyrie's offense. If they're able to convert, it would be really important for them. There's an injured Demons player on the field. Looks like number 78, Minttu Hurme. No, it's 76, Niina Perttunen. Both Perttunen and Hurme are one of more experienced alignments on Demons team. Perttunen doesn't look that bad. She's able to walk on her own, so hopefully she'll get back on the field soon. Valkyries continue with a two-back set, and they give it to the fullback. And Demons defense stays tough in the middle. Excellent tackle. Number 22 was in on that also, and some other defensive player. I didn't catch the number of the other one, but Annukka Savirinne
number 22 linebacker was there behind the line of scrimmage, and Demons offense is back on the field. Demons offense continues with a one back set, three receivers wide to the right. It's a pass play. It's a short pass to number 39, Heta Rantanen, but Möttönen's pass sails over her, and it's a second and 10 from 20-yard line. Demons come out in the same wide trips formation. This time it's a fake to Ruotsalainen, and Möttönen keeps the ball herself. She runs to the sideline, and offensive coordinator Salovalta is not totally happy with Möttönen's decision to almost walk out of the sideline. She could have probably gained a couple of yards extra even without hitting anybody. It's a third and 8 from 22-yard line. Again, the same formation, but this time it's to the narrow side of the field, so maybe a play to the wide side. Either a slant to the single side receiver, or maybe Möttönen will run to the left side. This time, number 16, Jenni Kangas, who's dropped a couple of balls in this game, and makes a big catch. Demons get some 15, 16 yards on that play and easily convert to first down. It's a first and 10 from Demons' 38-yard line. Demons' offense is able to move the change and keep the Valkyries' defense on the field. It's a quick pass to Elina Kero. She's tackled fast, but still it's a 4-yard gain. So Demons offense is really in schedule and keeps the sticks moving. It's a trips again, but tighter one with almost two tight ends on the right side. Möttönen boots out to the right side, and Katri Laine, who was on the wing, is able to get herself free on a wheel route. It's over a 10-yard gain again, and first and 10. Demons are over the half field on Valkyrie's 48-yard line. First and 10. They continue with the tight trips. This time it's Ruotsalainen to the trip side. She cuts back to the inside after bouncing first to the outside, but hard tackles. Valkyrie's defense, still a 4-yard gain. So second and 6. Demons offense have been able to convert really well on first down, so they're having much easier second and third downs than Valkyrie's most of the game. It's Ruotsalainen again, this time to the left side, and gets 3-4 yards again. Closer to 3 yards, 2.5. So it's third and 3. As we have already seen, Demons will most likely play both of these downs if they are not able to convert on this third down. So Valkyrie's defense really needs two stops again.
There's some movement, some D players over the ball, but probably it's on defense. Yes, it seems. Maybe the D line touched somebody on the offensive line, or some offensive player moved, reacting to defense, because they whistle it dead before the play was started. First and 10 with the penalty on defense. Tight trips to the right side. Pass. It's a short pass to number 39, Heta Rantanen. She's able to make a diving catch on her knees. 3-yard gain. Second and 7 from Valkyrie's 34-yard line. It's a cutback run. Ruotsalainen is able to break a couple of tackles on a line of scrimmage or close to line of scrimmage, and gets a good 5-yard gain. Is 3rd and 2. Demon's coaching staff is not happy because the offense comes up to the line pretty slow. It's a play action fake. Möttönen goes deep for Laine again. Laine made a good catch on the same play on the other side before on this drive, but this time number 80 on the defense is closer to the ball, almost gets an interception. Good coverage with Jelena Proskurikova. It's a 4th and 2. Coordinator Salovalta tried to go for the big one on a 3rd and 2 because he knew that he's going to play the 4th down. So now he can try to convert for the first. It's a pass. It's a slant to Kangas again, but this time ball drops to the ground before reaches her. So Valkyrie's offense is back on the field. There are almost 4 minutes on the clock, so Valkyrie's offense has good time. They used a couple of timeouts with their own defense in the red zone, but they still have enough time to march the whole field if they just are able to start converting. 14 comes in a motion. It's almost an interception with Heta Rantanen. That would have been really a pick six if she'd make it. Lukina was trying to throw to her running back, who was running the out route, Anna Liuter, number 33. It's a play action pass, almost a catch after number 88 make a good diving effort. She was well covered, but was able to get free in the end, but the ball just fell to the ground. It's 3rd and 10, so Valkyrie's offense is really in a tough spot because they really need to convert if they get give the ball back to Demons in a good field positions there. Demons are maybe able to score again, so a big down for Valkyries. It's an option to the right, and this time Lukina keeps it herself. There are a couple of flags on the play. Interesting to see what happens. And then there was I think that somebody blew the whistle too early, but the referees say that they blew the whistle too early, so the down will be replayed. This time Lukina was able to run by herself, almost untouched, would have gained at least 5-6 yards. So, a little bit unlucky whistle for Valkyries. This time she hands it off to number 33. But Demon's defense is not fooled on that play. Number 74, 66 and 78 all converge on the running back. Almost on a line of scrimmage. Only a 1 yard gain. And Valkyries change up to the punting formation. As mentioned, the quarterback Lukina is the punter also. So Demon's return team need to be wary of possible fakes on this one. It's a hop on a snap, but still good bounce on a kick. This time Anette Beckman has no problems fielding the punt, is able to get 5 yards on a return. And Demon's offense gets back on the field on a 44-yard line. They have a little bit over 2 minutes still on the clock. And I think that Demons have at least two or maybe even all of their timeouts left still. So they have a good chance to score in the end of first half. It's a pass play, quick pass out to number 16, Jenny Kangas. Pass is just a little bit short, but Kangas is still able to catch it. 3 yard gain, second and seven. Trips to the left side this time. Clock is running. It's a pass. Same play to the left side. Number 27, Johanna Pudas, is able to catch the ball. And this time Demons take their first timeout. Third and four around the half field. Valkyries really need to stop this drive, because three touchdowns for Demons on the first half would probably be a little bit too much on the second half. But two touchdowns, the difference is not that bad. It will be a trip to the wide side, right side of the field. Looks like a pass. Good protection. Line on a wheel route again, but just not able to get back to the ball. The pass is just a little bit too short. It's easier to throw the wheel to the narrow side of the field. This time it went to the wide side of the field, and even though that is not going forward that much, it's a long throw, and Möttönen is not able to make it. It's a fourth and four key down for both sides. Demons pass again. It's a pass to Pudas in the middle. She's well covered, but is able to fight through. Number, is it 21 on defensive side? Olga Rogovaya is close to Pudas, covering well, but she's not able to play the ball. And Pudas makes a contested catch again. Big play for Demons. There was a flag on the field, but referees did pick it up. Demons are lining up fast so that they don't have to use their timeouts yet. There's 1 minute still on the clock. Linek gets almost free behind the defenders. She bounces a little bit with one defender. No foul there, but that bounce is just able to slow her down enough that she can't make the catch. Second and two, around a minute to go. Trips to the wide side. It's a pass to the swing pass out to the running back Ruotsalainen. She's able to get around the four or five yards, and Demons call a timeout because the clock would have kept running. It's a third and five. Demons are almost on the red zone on a 20 and a half yard line, so they're getting pretty close to scoring on this drive too. It will be interesting to see if Salovalta goes for the big play again on a third down and tries to convert on the next fourth down if they don't make the catch on this play. It's a spread. There's a movement on the offensive line also. We'll see if the referee saw it. Yes. Number 66, left guard, moved. So it's third and 10. Because movement on the left side, that was a big mistake on Anna-Kaisa Saarenpää. Untouched splitter number 80. Demons head coach is a little bit mad, telling the referees that she hit the quarterback after the throw. Pretty close, have to admit. It wasn't a blatant foul, I'd say. But no flags there, so Möttönen had to throw under pressure and was not able to find the receiver. It's a fourth and 10. Möttönen throws to Elina Kero. The pass is well short. Falls to the ground 5-6 yards before Kero. So Valkyrie's offense is back on the field. There's only half a minute on a clock. So probably Valkyries just tried to run the clock away because their passing game is not that big threat. Correction on the time. Referees give a new time from from the field. It's 39 seconds, so a little bit more. Maybe a couple of pass plays to see if Valkyries get closer. It's a pass, and closest to the ball is Demons defender Tiina Suvioja. Not able to intercept, but able to defend the pass easily. Second and 10. Trips to the right. Lukina looks that way. Throws a pass. Number 27, Johanna Pudas, comes up and is the first to hit the pass. Not able to intercept on this time either. So, third and 10 for Valkyries. Demons defense have been really, really covering well on this drive. No free receivers downfield. Valkyries offense faces third and 10. It's a trips to the right side again. But it's a run play. They don't want to see the Demons offense back on the field. But Demons still have timeout left, so they can stop the clock on this fourth down. That's the last timeout for Demons, so they will have maybe around 20 seconds. We don't have the clock. The clock is not correct on the field, but the referee said it was 39 seconds before this. Now the play clock. Referee just yells out that the play clock is correct on the field, so 25 seconds on the field. If Valkyries probably gonna punt this, Demons don't have any timeouts, so it will be a hard task to score unless they get a really good return. Seems like Demons are going for the block. That would be, of course, a great field position to try to score still. We'll see what happens. It's a good snap, and they're not able to block it. And it seems that Anette Beckman muffs the punt again, and referees show that it's Valkyrie's ball. Seventeen seconds on the clock. Valkyries have the ball on midfield. We'll see what their decision is. I'd say that it would be maybe even a better chance to still score on a running play because their passes haven't been that dangerous. Because they need to cover this ground almost in one or two plays because they don't have any timeouts. And it's a run play, but Demons defense is not fooled. Number 66 and 22, Annukka Savirinne and Anna-Kaisa Saarenpää are there to meet on the running back behind the line of scrimmage. Valkyries take their last timeout. There is 9 seconds on the clock. Trip to the right side. Lukina looks that way.
throws a crossing route, but Tiina Suvioja is there to intercept the ball. Only chance to score on this is to take this all the way, because the clock goes to the zero. But a great interception on the last play of the half. And this is the end of the half, 14-0 for Demons. And we'll have a short break here on the commentary booth. We'll get back to you when the play resumes. Hello and welcome back to this live stream from Women's Maple League, Helsinki Demons against St. Petersburg Valkyries. Teams are getting ready for the second half. Demons are leading 14-0. Valkyries defense was playing really well for the first couple of drives, but then Demons got a little bit an upper hand and have been able to score twice. They had a couple of other scoring chances in the end of the half, but Valkyries were able to hold them off at that time. After the beginning, Demons have been able to both run and pass, but maybe in the end especially even a pass a little bit more. Their leading runners are number 85 Anu Ruotsalainen and 13 Katri Laine with couple of runs and a pass and Tiina Möttönen, the quarterback, her passes have gone to several different players. Number 16 Jenni Kangas, number 27 Johanna Pudas, number 41 Elina Kero, tight end, has couple of great catches. Also running back and a wing back Katri Laine has couple of catches, so Möttönen has been able to spread it out really well. On defensive side, Demons have also been playing really good team defense, and there have been several good tackles from many different players. On Valkyrie's side, quarterback Lyubov Lukina hasn't really been able to find out that many free receivers, and their leading rusher is number 33, Anna Liuter. So it will be interesting to see if there are any big changes. I think that at least Demons think that they don't need that many changes, but we'll see how Valkyrie's offense comes out. They were forced to pass maybe a little bit more than they would have liked, because they didn't really get the pass game going on the first half, so maybe they'll come out running a little bit more this half. Number 16, Jenni Kangas, is getting ready for the kick, and Valkyrie's return players are ready for the ball. Number 89 gets the ball, starts to work towards the left side from the right side, is able to break the first line of contain, and she will score. There are no flags on the field, so a great start for Valkyries for this second half. Number 89, Daria Briuk-Ovetskaya, is able to score on the return. Excellent play. It first looked like a little bit bad decisions to start running towards the left sideline from all the way from the right side. She was running backwards even in the beginning of the return, but she really showed her speed and was able to break the contain on Demons' kickoff team. Valkyries are going for two. It's a pass. Lukina is looking number 13. And yes, she makes the catch. Valkyries come up really, really strong to start the second half, and it's 14-8. This was really good for the game. Good confidence booster for Valkyries, and it will be an interesting second half. Number 13, Olga Vorobeva, was able to catch Lukina's pass on the two-point conversion. Demons are, of course, the much more experienced team here, but Valkyries have really good athletes, play really hard, and I think that this return gave them really a good confidence booster. So they will be probably fired up to start the second half. Quarterback is the punter and also the kicker, so here comes the kickoff. It's a bouncing ball. Some confusion in the ranks of Demons return men. Annette Beckman handles the return, has a decent return to the 35-yard line, but maybe a little bit mixed up with Anu Ruotsalainen, who's going to take the ball. They let them bounce it right in between them. First and 10 from 35-yard line. Demons offense back to the field. They come out in one back set with Katri Laine next to Möttönen and two receivers on both sides. Seems that coordinator Salovalta is changing the play on the line. Looks like a pass play. It's a quick pass to Anette Beckman, who works on the offensive side of the ball also, but throw falls short, and it's second and 10. Trips to the right side. Katri Laine continues to be the running back. It's a run play. Laine takes it, bounces it out. First goes to the middle, but bounces it out to the right side. He's able to get a good gain, 7-8 yards on the right side. It was a good pull from number 66, Anna-Kaisa Saarenpää. It's a third and 3. Trips to the left side. Möttönen and Laine are talking it through. They're on the same page. And Möttönen runs herself. Excellent play from a number 89, Daria Brukhov-Vetskaya, who made the excellent return to start the half. So no surprises there that she has the speed. It's a fourth and 3. Demons elect to go for it. We'll see if they play or if it's only trying to throw the defense on offside, but they're forced to take a timeout. There was a mishap on the formation, and they figured out that they don't have a time to get the play going, or they weren't happy with the defense they were seeing. Salovalta calls timeout. Of course, we have almost two quarters to play the play still, but on a mental side, this would be a really critical stop for Valkyries if they scored and then get the stop immediately. It would be great for them. Demons offense is ready. Anu Ruotsalainen is back as a running back, trips to the right side. That's the wide side of the field. They're trying to throw the defense offside, but they're not able. And it's again passed to Johanna Pudas. She has it on her hands, but the cornerback is able to hit her after that, and she is not this time. She has made a couple of really good contested catches, but this time she's not able to hold on. So it's a first and 10 from Demons' 42-yard line for Valkyries. I think that they will be really excited and fired up to start the second half with this Lukina's pass fell short. She was trying to throw it to number 14, Oksana Arbatova, but it fell to the ground a couple of yards before her. Second and 10. Trips punch to the right side. There's plenty of room on the left. And that's a really, really good catch. Between three defenders, tight ball for number 22. Lukina looked at the right first and then came back to the left side. And I think that they're gonna measure it. It's pretty close to the first down. There's the measurement and looks like it's just few inches short. We'll get, yes, it's a third down, so they'll have a two downs to convert on this, because I am pretty sure that they will play the fourth down even if they're not getting it on the first try. Back set. Toss to the right. They're able to convert, but there's a flag on the play. Back charge through. Yes, and it's a holding on number 14. Wide receiver Oksana Arbatova. She was making a key block on the edge, but she gets the flag for the hold, so it will be third and 10. It will be third and 8, because or even third and 7, because the penalty was a little bit on upfield. So third and 7 for Valkyries. It's a play action and a post to number 22, but Tiina Suvioja, who had the interception to end the first half, is really tight on the coverage and is able to break on the ball. The ball was from just a little bit behind, and that helped Suvioja, but she was on a tight coverage also. It's a fourth and 7. Arbatova again in a motion. It's an option to the left side. The beach back is free. Annette Beckman comes in for a tackle, but number 33, Anna Liuter, is able to carry Beckman for additional 5-6 yards, and it's easily a first down. It's a first and 10 from 26-yard line of Demons, so looking good for Valkyries. If they'd be able to score on this with a two-point conversion, they'd go and take the lead. It's a play-action pass to the middle. It's Arbatova again, and this time she's able to catch it in a hard traffic, and is even able to get a couple of yards after that. So first down again. Uh,
Good usage of play action passes from Valkyries. They have been able to get players free behind the linebackers. It's first and 10 from 12-yard line. Now Demons' defense really needs to toughen up. Toss to the right. Great blocks on the edge. And number 89 scores again. Number 89, Daria Brjuk-Ovetskaya, who scored on the return already, takes the ball to the right side. Great, great blocks on the edge by Valkyrie's offensive line and wide receivers. And great finish, even though Anette Bäckman was trying to make the tackle, Daria was able to break it. It's a 14-14 and a second and a two-point conversion coming up. They come out in empty set. The running back runs a swing out of the motion and is able to score. Number 88, Angelina Stepkina, comes in out of the empty set as a running back and continues directly to the swing. Lukina finds her and she's able to take it all the way. 14-16 and Valkyries have the first lead on the game. Also seems that Anette Bäckman, who's been in on three late tackles on this drive, has been dragged around a little bit. Seems to injure herself in the corner. Hope that it's nothing that serious and she'll get back to the game soon. But great stuff from Valkyries, especially the play action passes worked really well. Lukina was able to find receivers pretty well behind the linebackers. Some good catches, and the game is really tight again. Excellent start for Valkyries for this second half. Also seems that Bäckman is injured a little bit more, so she's not cutting up yet. So that's one key player more missing from Demons. We'll follow the situation and see if she gets back to the game. Lukina is ready for the kickoff. Ruotsalainen is waiting for the ball. Ruotsalainen cannot catch the ball from the air. Loses some time on that. And number 21 makes a good tackle on the open field. Olga Rogovaja. Demons will start their offense from 37... around 37-yard line. And it's first and 10. I think that this is a big confidence booster for Valkyries, but Demons are so experienced. Many players who have played for several years or even over 10 years of football have seen it all, so they are not worried at the moment yet. Trips to the right. Ruotsalainen takes the ball there behind good blocks from the receivers. But excellent tackle coming from Valkyrie's defense. But it's already a 6-7 yard gain. And it's second and 4. Trips to the left side. We'll see if the ball comes this way. No. Yes, it comes, but excellent tackle from number 79, Veronika Jatsina. She's able to break through from the line and catches Ruotsalainen from behind. Although Ruotsalainen got really good, she fell forward for a couple of yards, so it's a third and a half yard. Good blocking up front.
Number 66, Anna-Kaisa Saarenpää, is pulling again in front of Ruotsalainen, and they easily take the first down. Demons offense really comes back to the field furious and starts to move the ball really well. Demons working from a two-back set, but it's not working at all. Number 22, Annukka Savirinne, gets the ball, but she's met immediately behind the line of scrimmage. Leading the charge was, I think, number 60, or was it number 80? Yes, I think it was number 80, Jelena Proskurikova. Demons coaching staff is talking with the referees. They're not happy with the spot. It's 2nd and 17, so long way to go. Demons go to the air. Great catch by number 39, Heta Rantanen. But it's a short pass. They cover about the half, maybe a little bit more out of that 17. So it'd be 3rd and 7. 3rd and 8. Key third down. It's a counter. Excellent blocks. Katri Laine is able to run for a first down untouched and gains an additional 6 to 7 yards after that. It's a 1st and 10 from a 32-yard line. So Demons are closing in on the red zone. Valkyries coaching staff calls a timeout. They are not happy to see the Demons moving ball that well. But that was excellently blocked counter. Number 22, Annukka Savirinne, was pulling behind the line and had the great lead block for Katri Laine. After the timeout, it's 1st and 10. Demons come out in a two-back set. It looks like it's going to be a toss to the left side. No, it's a swing pass to Katri Laine. It's a lateral pass. Laine drops the ball but is able to cover it, but it's a negative gain again. Valkyrie's defense has been able to be more aggressive on this start of the second half than in the end of the first half. It looks more to the way they started the game and are making a place on a Demons backfield again. It's a counter to the left side this time, but this time Valkyrie's played better. Number 33, Anna Liutter, was there first. She wasn't able to make the tackle, but she was able to slow down Katri Laine just enough that her teammates were able to wrap up easily after that. 3rd and 13. It's a quick pass to Savirinne, but she's well covered and is not able to catch the ball. That was behind, in the middle of three defenders. That was a pretty risky throw. It could have been easily intercepted. Demons went for it really fast. Valkyrie's defense was not totally set, but I think that they tried a little bit too much there, and going that fast might have hurt themselves more. It's 4th and 13, but Demons elect to go for it. They're not punting in this field position. It's probably either a delay of game or too many men on field. No, there's an false start, number 76. There's some discussion between the referees and Demons coaching staff, but the penalty is not going to change, and it's 4th and 18. Ruotsalainen and Laine are switching position. Laine gets behind Möttönen as a running back, runs the swing, gets the ball, but is well covered by Valkyrie's defense. Just gains a couple of yards, and Valkyrie's offense is back on the field. Seems like Demons head coach Mika Eloranta is not really happy about that call. Luckily, didn't change anything on that drive. They would have had 4th and 13 anyway, and would have been really hard to convert. It's a running back screen out wide. Wide receivers out of the trips bunch formation started to block immediately downfield, and they did block well. Number 88, Angelina Stepkina, caught the swing pass from Lukina and was able to run behind the great blocks of her teammates for a first down. Tiina Suvioja made the tackle, but she gained already over 10 yards. Two running backs said, first and 10 in the midfield. It's a toss to the right. Great blocks again. Number 89 makes a couple of linebackers, both Elina Kero and Venla Nikula, the miss after great blocks. She fumbles the football in the end. But great blocks. Again, there is plenty of running room for Valkyrie's running backs. Number 89, Daria Bryukovetskaya, injures herself just a little bit. Doesn't look that bad. She fell on her shoulder. She's been scoring there both touchdowns, so hopefully she gets back. Lukina keeps the ball herself on the first and 10. There's a flag on the field. And out of the picture, we can tell that Anette Bäckman is still injured outside of the sideline. They're just now starting to carry her back on her own side. There's an illegal formation on Valkyries on that play. That's a shame for them because it's a 5-yard penalty. It's first and 15, but they had a nice gain on Lukina's run on the previous play. And now it starts to rain again. We'll see if that affects the ball handling on the field. First and 15
from 38-yard line. Valkyrie is on the move again. Lukina keeps the ball herself, pitches to number 88. This time the option works well. Lukina is able to pitch the ball after running a few yards, but there's a flag on the backfield of offense. It's probably going to be a holding or a clipping, and this will come back again. Yes, it's a holding against the offense. So now Valkyrie is having problems with penalties, and their offense is moving backwards. It will be first and 25. That's a lot to cover for Valkyries, because they haven't had that much success with the pass game. They have had a couple of good passes deep, but many passes have been close to interceptions also. So we'll see what happens. They come out with the trips to the right. Lukina looks to the single receiver side, but they're not on the same page. Lukina tries to throw it quickly for a short route, but the receiver is running deep. Second and 25. That was a good call, tried to take some of the yardage back. Cornerback was playing deep enough for the quick pass, but the receiver number 22 wasn't on the same page with Lukina. Trips punch to the right. It's an option to the left. Lukina's own run is taken away immediately, and Katri Laine and Anu Ruotsalainen, both running backs, this time on defense, converge on the running back immediately, and it's no gain. Third and 25. This was a good-looking drive from Valkyries, but those two penalties really did kill it. They almost had a second and four, but it turned to first and 25 with two penalties. It's a screen to the middle, and there's plenty of space, but Katri Laine makes a great play. There was plenty of green field for Liuter, number 33, and she had good blockers in head of her, but Katri Laine comes between the blocks and makes the tackle after just a couple of yards gain. So it's fourth and 20-21. Looks like Valkyries are going to punt. Johanna Pudas is the punt returner because Beckman is out. It's a decent punt, about 20 yards, but Demons get the ball back on their own 25-yard line. So first and 10 for Demons. The third quarter is coming close to an end. 1:50 to go. Demons come out in a two tight end set. Ruotsalainen has a single setback. She gets nice blocks through the hole and gets 6 to 7 yards. Nice carry, but there is an injured Valkyrie player on the ground. Looks like number 22 is okay. She just needs to get off the field because the play was whistled dead because her injury. I think that she'll be back after a few downs. Didn't look that serious. She got a big hit from Ruotsalainen, who was carrying the ball and lowered her shoulders. Run straight into number 22.
Ruotsalainen continues to be the tailback, and Savirinne is next to her as a fullback, but Katri Laine, playing this time tight end, takes a false start, and Demons offense is going back for 5 yards. It's 2nd and 8. Offensive coordinator Salavalta tries to be funny guy on the sideline, calling for the same play, and then adds, but no false start on this time. It's a run to Savirinne, a trap play, and an excellent blocked trap play it is. They gain over close to 20 yards on that, so easily a first down. We see again number 66, Anna-Kaisa Saarenpää, pulling this time, kicking out on a trap. She's been really on the move on the offensive line. Good blocks on the edge for Ruotsalainen, and gets 8 to 9 yards on a quick bounce play to the outside. Demons offense is really trying to hurry it up, and I think it's a good call from their part, because that was working for them really well on the first half also. Valkyrie's defense really slowed down when Demons got the plays going on fast. They're able to get an over 10 yards again on a run play. This time it's Ruotsalainen to the right side. It's a 1st and 10 from 31-yard line of Valkyries. And again, Valkyries defense looks a little bit tired. There are a couple of players leaning on their knees again. Valkyries call a timeout, and it's their 2nd timeout on this half. That might be big if it's a tight game and they need the timeouts in the end. But anyway, I think it's a good call from their coaching staff. Again, they see that their players are getting tired and Demons are running all over them. Timeout is closing to its end. Demons come out in a single back set. Trips right, tight. There are Elina Kerro and Katri Laine as a tight end and a wing back. Katri Laine runs the wheel again, but Möttönen is under heavy, heavy pressure and is not able to get the ball nowhere close to Laine. So it's 2nd and 10. After an incomplete pass. Referee is asking for medical staff to get to the other side. So there is some injury on Valkyrie's sideline. And the play continues. And the trend continues with the Demons also. They're able to get 8 to 9 yards or even more with their running plays at the moment. Excellent blocking, nobody touched Ruotsalainen until she was all through the linebacker level already. It's a 3rd and 1. And if Salovalta, the offensive coordinator, continues his trend, they might go for it all on this down. This time they want to take the first down on this 3rd down already. And they are able to do that, just that, with a 4-yard gain up the middle with Ruotsalainen behind block of 76, Nina Perttunen. Perttunen is a little bit banged up, but she's able to get up on her own.
And there seems to be timeout on... No, it's not a timeout. It's end of the quarter on the field. So teams can take just a quick breather, drink some water, and get back to the action. Again, it seems that the Demons' offense is on the roll, but Valkyrie's defense is capable for big plays, so this is not automatic touchdown for them. Valkyries can easily come up with a tackle for loss or force them to some other errors. So, first and 10, just inside the red zone, around Valkyrie's 18-yard line. It's a run play to Laine, but this time she's met close to the scrimmage, but she shows her strength again. She's able to carry a couple of Valkyrie's players for about 4 yards. It's second and long 6. Demons come out in a two-back set. Play is coming to the right side, probably. And here we go. A big play just behind the line of scrimmage, but Ruotsalainen is able to fall forward for a half, and maybe a yard again. So it's... third and long 5. Number 79, Veronika Jatsina, was there on the first with her teammates stacking up after that. It's a run play to the right for Ruotsalainen. She tries to get outside, but is not able and cuts back in, but number 80 is there to meet her. Jelena Brosku-Rikova, excellent play by her. First forcing the play back in and then making the tackle herself. And tackle for loss it was. It's a 4th and 6. Crucial down for both teams. It's a pass play, but nowhere near the completion. I'm not really sure if Möttönen just overthrew that, or if she was waiting for some other route from either of the inside receivers. Elina Kero was crossing the field really shallow, and Möttönen threw it deeper to the middle. But it's incomplete, so just as we predicted, Valkyries were able to come up with a big play on their red zone with a couple of tackles near the scrimmage and force Demons to give up the ball after the incomplete pass. Two back set, motion to Arbatova, run to the middle, good blocking. They are calling it a forward pass. Have to admit that didn't really see what happened there, but that's what the call on the referee is also. I thought that there was a tackle behind. Let's see if we can find out. Yes, it was Lukina who kept the ball. It was a forward pass after that. But illegal men downfield. Have to admit that I think that the receiver was still behind the line of scrimmage when she got that. Nonetheless, that's the call.
It's second and 15. This is a toss to the right. They get a 5 yard back out of that. It's a third down. Third and 10 for Valkyries. As we can see, there are some small mistakes with Valkyries, maybe a little bit due to inexperience, which have kept them back a little bit. They make a great play, and after that, a small mistake. Now there's a short pass to number 89, a swing pass, but then there's a holding on the receiver, I'd say. There's a flag on the field. And we'll see. This is interesting call. Will the Demons deny the penalty and take it? It would be around 4 and 5 deep into the Valkyries' end. Or if they take it back, it would go around 7 yard line. There is again some mix-up with the referees because they weren't asking if they want to deny the penalty, and the defense, the Demons coaching staff yells after that. No, we don't want to take the penalty. We'll take the play, but they don't have the correct spot anymore. Maybe it was around that. I think it was maybe a yard or two forward. But Valkyries brings up their punting unit. It's a good snap. Lukina gets the punt away. It's a good punt. Katri Laine fields it, but number 54, Aleksandra Mansurova, is there immediately to meet her. Good tackle on special teams by Mansurova. Demons will get the ball in midfield. It's first and 10 from Valkyrie's 48-yard line. Even though that it seems that the Demons are at the moment playing better, they're advancing on offense and stopping on defense, it's still, and as I just said, that Anu Ruotsalainen fumbles the ball. But I was saying anyway that it's still Valkyries who lead, and now they even get the ball back immediately after Ruotsalainen's fumble. This is a big blow for Demons because even though that there are still almost 9 minutes left, Demons haven't been able to score that quickly on any point of this game, because Valkyrie's defense, even though a little bit tired at times, has been able to prevent most of the big plays for Demons and have been able to make big plays of their own. It's a play action pass, and number 14 is totally wide open again. After that, number 16, Jenni Kangas, misses the tackle, and Oksana Arbatova takes it all the way. Valkyries continue what is working for them. Great, great call from their offensive coordinator. Play action has been really good for them. Arbatova gets behind the linebackers just before the safety. And because of injury to Anette Beckman, Jenni Kangas is in as a free safety, but she misses the tackle, and Arbatova takes it all the way. I was just saying that the Demons are a little bit on the top, even though that they're 2 points behind, But then Famborttu Ruotsalainen, and a great call and great execution by Lukina and Arbatova, make it a touchdown for Valkyries, and they even convert on 2 points. So it's 14-24, which means that it's a 2-score difference. Demons need at least a touchdown with an extra point and a field goal even to get even. We haven't seen much of a kicking game out of from Demons this game because they're a regular kicker is out, and Jenni Kangas has been kicking the ball. Looking at the kickoffs, it's probably safe to say that she's not able to make the field goal from that far away. So this probably means that Demons need 2 touchdowns to get back on the top. And of course they need to keep Valkyries from scoring more. Lukina, after that great throw to Arbatova, is getting ready for the kickoff. And Laine is getting ready to receive. Tiina Möttönen, the quarterback, takes the ball as the other returner, and a great return, but there is flag on the field, which probably in these situations means that the play is coming back. Möttönen is able to return the ball to the 40-yard line of Valkyries, but there is flag on Demon's side of the field, which probably means that it's going to be 1st and 10 from around 38-yard line. It's clipping, and 1st and 10 from 38-yard line. Demons have plenty of time on the clock, but they really can't take a long drive here and not score, because that would take too much away from the clock. I think that Saloranta is not going with it for all the time, because there is so much time on the clock, but they really need to get the first downs anyway. And they start out with a run play to Laine. Good hard running, but good hard tackling also. Laine is able to get 4 to 5 yards. Clock is working for the Valkyries at the moment. They can really let the Demons run 4 to 5 yards as long as they're not breaking up any longer gains. It's a wide receiver screen to Johanna Pudas. She cuts it back out. Looks like she's going to able to break it for a long gain. But Valkyrie's team speed on defense shows up again, and they're able to tackle Pudas before the first down. It will be 3rd and a long 1. It's a run to Laine on the middle. She breaks the first tackle, 2nd, 3rd, and she's off to the races. Great running by Laine. First, it was the offensive line who made, again, a great blocks. Laine was able to break it through, but then it was all on her. She was breaking 4 to 5 tackles on that run. She's really hard to bring down. But still, Valkyries are able to run her down and not let them score on this already. There's injured Valkyrie on the field again. Hopefully nothing bad. No, it seems that it was their timeout. Excuse me, sorry for that. Valkyries used their last timeout. Seems that every time Demons get a big play, they want to give their defense some rest. It has worked well this far. After the timeout, Valkyrie's defense have been able to make many stops. 1st and 10, just outside of the red zone. It's tossed to Ruotsalainen to the left side, but great defense from number 80, Jelena Prosku-Rikova. takes away the outside and is in on the tackle also. But seems that she might have injured herself. No, it's not Elena, it's some other player. I'm not sure what's happening there, but they're helping out. I can't see the number, coach's hand on the number. But she's able to, whoever she is able to walk on her own. Fripp's punch to the right. Second and 10. It's a counter to the left. Linus shows powerful running again. Looks like she's going to be tackled on a tap, on a scrimmage. Then looks like she's tackled for a 5-yard gain. But she's pushed out after she gets the first down. And they're pretty close to the 10-yard line. I'd say that they're on a 10.5, maybe. Yeah, 10.5-yard line. So in theory, they can even get the first down before the score, but there's only like half a yard difference between the first down and the goal line. Two back set. Let's see if it's a Laine again. No, it's Savirinna this time up the middle. Good run play. Six yards. Demons staff yelling to their own players that keep the pace up, but unfortunately there is an injury to Demons player, because Demons staff is seeing the same as we have been noticing, that Valkyrie's defense is really gassed up. Savirin injures herself a little bit. She is helped out from the field. And it's Demons second and 4, just inside the 5-yard line. It seems it's a play action pass coming. Boottu Möttönen, pass, it's way too long in the air, number 22 intercepts it easily. Luckily for Demons, Möttönen is able to tackle number 22 after her own interception. That was a bad throw from Möttönen. Line was open on the flat, but ball was in the air for a long time. It was a high pass for a short area. And number 22, Olga Nenechkina, is able to make the crucial interception. There are 6 minutes on the clock, but as we were talking, Demons still need 2 scores to get back on the top. And now Valkyries are in a great position to chew up some clock. Liuter gets the ball up the middle. Gets 4 yards, and that's a really good first down for Valkyries. If they're able to chew up the clock with 6 to 7 runs on this drive, Demons are in real hurry. Also, we can tell you that it's starting to rain a little bit harder here, which would make Demons' pass game even more difficult. Lukina tosses it, but tosses muffed, but 88 is luckily able to take the ball from one bounce. But here we can see some small inexperience on her part, because she was running out of bounds, which stops the clock for a while after. If she had kept herself in bounds, it would have been the clock would have been running. Lukina calls 89 back out of the empty set. Next to her, they try to pass to Arbatova, player who scored the last long touchdown. Pass fell short, and Valkyries are punting. So this was a good series for Demons defense. They're able to get the ball back immediately and still have over five minutes to score. So the game is still wide open. Katri Laine drops back to return the punt. And Arbatova covers the punt immediately. Tries to advance with it, but obviously cannot. So Demons have the ball on 48-yard line. First and 10, but the downs are not that important at the moment. They need to score fast. 5 minutes seems a lot, but with the heavy rain and Möttönen not able to throw that deep, 5 minutes isn't too much. They come out in a pretty tight set. It's probably a run or a play action. It's run to Laine. Some miscommunication on the handoff. Snap was maybe a little high for Möttönen, so it took a little bit time to get the ball to Laine, which allows the Valkyrie's defense to converge on her really quickly. Only 1 yard gain, second down. And the clock is running. It's a pass play. A lot of pushing and shoving, but it goes both ways. It was number 16 on Demons and number 80 on Valkyrie's side. They were both pushing and shoving, so referees didn't see anything wrong with that. It's the referee spots the ball on the wrong yard line, but they will correct it. So it's 3rd and 9. Almost game on the line. Möttönen has again hard time handling the snap. It bounces on her hands, and this means that Ruotsalainen doesn't get to full speed, and Valkyrie stopped the play almost dead on the line of scrimmage. Half, maybe a yard again. 4th and long 8. I'd say that this is almost a game on the line for Valkyries. If they stop this, they are able to chew the clock. It's a lateral pass, which drops to the ground, and Ruotsalainen is forced just to cover it up, because it was a fourth down at Valkyrie's ball on a 45-yard line. And I'd say that as long as they don't fumble or give the ball away, they are able to chew up the clock. Of course, Demons have their timeout still, but because Demons need 2 scores, they would have to give the ball back to Valkyries. In football, almost 4 minutes still, so anything is open, but Valkyries are in a good spot. Lukina keeps it herself, but again, she runs out of bounds and stops the clock. Second and 7. Trips to the right, punch formation. It's run to the middle. But there is a D end. I think it's a number 55, Venla Nikula, I'd say. Yes, Venla Nikula makes a good tackle after 2 yard gain, but the clock keeps running. 3rd and 5. And Valkyries obviously try to use all of the play clock and keep the clock running. We're under 3 minutes. Trips to the right again.
punch formation. It seems to be a reverse to Arbatova. Ruotsalainen is there and can make the tackle. Great defense from 85 Anu Ruotsalainen. It first looked like that the game's play is gonna go a long way for a new set of downs, but Ruotsalainen came through the blocks and made the saving tackle. It's a fourth down from 41 yard line, and Valkyries marched their punting unit to the field. Demons are probably going to come with a heavy block on this and try to block the ball. Lukina's punts have been quite decent with a good bounce on Velodromi field. This could go deep. It's a little bit bad snap, but Lukina is able. Valkyries down the ball inside the Demons 20-yard line, around 17, 18-yard line. So, there is some yelling going back and forth with officials and Demons coaching staff, but nothing too serious. They're just changing the balls for the dry ones. So 2.5 minutes, Demons need to score really, really fast to have even a shot in this game. It's a run play to Ruotsalainen, great blocks in the on the edge. Katri Laine throws number 23 to the ground. Ruotsalainen runs to the pile. And it's a first down. Little bit over 10 yards. But after the clock starts to run after the whistle, because Ruotsalainen didn't step out of bounds. It's a pass play, quick pass to Pudas. Tackle is made immediately. It's a 3 to 4 yard gain, but that doesn't stop the clock, which is even more important. We're under 2 minutes. And the clock is ticking. Pass play to Pudas again with the same conclusion. 3 yard gain, and clock keeps running, which means that the Demons are forced to take a timeout. I think that it was their second timeout. Because Demons' offense isn't that high-powered anymore this year. They need to score fast, probably break a tackle after a catch or break a long run, and then they would still need the onside kick and score again. We have 1:36 on the clock, 3rd and 3. Obviously, they first have to convert, but as I said, downs aren't that important anymore. They need to score. It's a pass. A short pass to Elina Kero. She tries to get out of bounds, but she doesn't get even the first down and doesn't get out of bounds. So the clock keeps running. It's fourth and one. If Valkyries are able to stop this, it's the end of the game. We're almost down to 1 minute. It's a run play to Ruotsalainen, though, so they elected to take the first down, which they obviously needed, but were happy with just a run. But there's flag on the field. Ruotsalainen was able to get the first down, but we'll see what the flag is for. It seems it's a face mask on Valkyries, so Demons get an additional 15 yards for that. But still, they're in a really big hurry. 57 seconds on the clock, and they're just past the half line. Trips to the right. It's a pass play. Möttönen has plenty of time. Decides to run herself, but doesn't run out of bounds. It's a big mistake on her part. She should have run out of bounds. Stop the clock. The clock is running. It's a second and two around 38-yard line. That took at least 15, maybe 20 seconds off the clock. She should have run out of bounds. Wasn't able. It's a new set of downs. The clock stops for the time that they move the sticks, but it's only 18 seconds on the clock. Valkyries are going to win this one. Clock should have started already. Didn't start. This stops the clock. Valkyries gained a couple of, they lost a couple of seconds. It should have started on the whistle, but it doesn't matter anymore. They will win this game. There is no chance that the Demons are going to score two touchdowns. So, big congratulations for Valkyries. Women's football is really catching up in Russia. And of course, we hope that they would start to get their own series up and running. And now the game is officially closed. Number 25 takes a great interception, and she will return it all the way. Great, great play to finish this game. Number 25, Xenia Derebiaiskaya. And the game ends on this touchdown. I don't know why they didn't let them play the extra point, because the goal difference might be come into the play, but we'll go with the score of 14-30. Valkyries win this tight game. Demons had many opportunities, but were a couple of times denied on the red zone by Valkyries. Tough defense. They really did pick themselves up. They were really tired during the couple of Demons long drives, but when their own goal line started to get closer, they did really well, picked it up and made some big plays. Excellent game from Valkyries. We're really hoping that they get on Russia, they start to get their own teams, so that they can play in their own series, because Valkyries have to play every game as an away game at the moment, because they play in Finnish league. So even though Valkyries home games are marked as a home games on the schedule, they play them in Finland. Number 89, Daria Bryuk-Ovetskaya, the scorer of first two goals, and many critical plays on defense, also gets the MVP for Valkyries. And
And Katri Laine, number 13, gets the best player for home team.
So, thank you for everybody. Hope you had a great time with this live stream. And a big congrats to Valkyries. If you want to see the interview for both head coaches and MVPs, please stay us with a while still. They will be coming for interviews quite soon.
All right, we have here the winning team, head coach and the MVP of the game. Head coach Ilya Kravchov. Did I get that close enough?
More or less, yeah.
Okay, big congrats on the win on a Demons. What would you say was the turning point of this game? Where did you get the feeling that we're going to win this one?
Well, tactically, we didn't have to make a whole lot of adjustments. We just corrected the mistakes we were doing in the first half. And at halftime, we just corrected them and played a more concentrated football and just eliminated our own mistakes. Like, really, we didn't do much of the adjustments. That was one factor, I think, that happened in the halftime. And the other was physicality. I think in the second half, we were able to wear them out. And, they're also, our defense was also barely holding their ground. But offensively, I think we were able to wear them down and run the ball effectively and kill the clock.
All right. That looked really good, especially what you said about the defense. I noticed that you used quite a lot of timeouts to get some rest for your defense, and it did work very well. You made really many critical stops on the red zone or close to your own red zone. That was good coaching.
Thank you.
You're obviously pretty happy with your team today, but who would you say that were the biggest players for you today? Of course, in addition to 89 here, who got the MVP?
I think our defensive line did a hell of a job because as you may have seen, we all played three defensive linemen, and they were matched up against probably the biggest and the toughest offensive line of the Vaterliga. And I think they may, considering the fact that there was only three of them, and they weren't even the starters. Like, we only had two starters there, and one of them was also injured. So considering that, I think our defensive line made a huge impact. And also in our passing game, all of our wide receivers that caught the passes, especially Oksana Arbatova in the end when she scored, I think, the deciding touchdown. In this kind of wet conditions, you know, it's tough to hang on to the football, but they managed to do that, and I think that was also a big impact on the result of the game.
Yeah, good stuff. How about the opponent? Were they doing what you were expecting, or any surprises there?
Not really. Again, as we all know, on the offensive side of the ball, they have a lot of injuries, and so they have to play with what they have, you know. So it kind of feels like somewhat of a makeshift like offense. But they were trying to play the same kind of offense they were playing all year long, and I think we were more or less ready for that.
All right. So, any words in Russia for viewers in Russia?
Еще раз всем хочу сказать спасибо за то, что сделали эту трансляцию возможным. Да, сегодняшняя победа, да, это, наверное, мы посвящаем, да, всем тем, кто нам помогал, и всей футбольной семье у нас дома. Спасибо огромное.
Good stuff. Didn't understand any of that, but big congrats to you guys. All right, and then we have the MVP of Valkyries here, Daria Bryukhovetskaya. Close enough? Okay, congrats for you also to the win. What are your first feelings after this big win?
Это неожиданно, это очень приятно, очень девчонки большие, молодцы, и мы молодцы не только в защите, но и я хочу похвалить тех игроков, которых всегда меньше всего видно. Это наш онлайн, который сделал сегодня огромнейшую работу и подвел нас к этому. И также перехват наших дебеков, это тоже очень здорово и очень нам помогло.
Can we get some translation from you, coach?
So, yeah, of course, it was somewhat unexpected, but naturally everybody is extremely happy. And in particular, she wants to point out the players at the positions that don't usually get much attention, especially our offensive line that allowed us and helped us control the game, as well as the defensive backs that were able to make a couple of key interceptions.
Good stuff. Where did you see that your team was really good today, and where maybe you could do some better in the next games? Any comments?
Где были наши сильные стороны сегодня, и что еще нужно исправить?
На самом деле у нас есть, мне кажется, достаточно сторон, над которыми надо работать, но в общем и целом мне сегодня показалась игра достаточно слаженной и хорошей.
Right, so naturally, like every team, we still have like some areas that we can improve, but today's game was pretty even from the point of view of, you know, being like a whole team effort.
All right, I really agree, and really big congrats, and we hope to see more teams come up in Russia, and probably the Russian national team is going to be the team to beat in future, at least from your point of view.
Of course, thank you, thank you. We're working towards that.
Okay, great game. Have a nice trip back home.
Thank you, thank you.
And then we will have head coach of Demons team and MVP from Demons, just in a second.
Mika!
Varmaan Lontoos.
Joo.
Miten me mahutaan? Vai tulee Katri samaan?
Tää on live-striimi sit koko ajan.
All right, and now we have a sadly the losing team today, home team Demons here. First, head coach Mika Eloranta, what was the key turning point in this game today?
We were out of gas, so we a little bit short roster and just ran out of fuel.
Yeah, it seemed that especially Valkyrie's defense was running out of fuel too, but they were able to come up with key stops on the red zone.
Yeah, and of course we had very crucial turnovers, two interceptions in the red zone, lost fumble. So if you have six turnovers, so that's you cannot on tough games you don't win on six turnovers.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. How about which players you want to raise from your team who were good today? Of course, Katri got the MVP, but any other?
Of course, the number 13, Katri, was awesome today. Line time to time on first half, defense line was good. We didn't let Valkyries to have many yards, but of course, Johanna Pudas was on the first half, was very good on defense side, so Pudas and Katri were the key points, key players today.
How about the opponent? Were they what you were expecting or anything new?
Nothing new. We had scouted their offense from the Crocodiles game last week, and there was nothing surprising. They were just better today, so we knew the option, and we had practiced all week on the options, so that was nothing new to us. The one middle screen, we knew that it was coming on against Crocodiles. They had five very successful middle screen for us, only one, and we took the first one out, so they didn't try it again. So, yeah, nothing what we didn't expect.
All right, but in a tough games, it's a small mistakes or small. Small good plays on either sides, and so that's the end score today.
Yeah.
Thank you. Any last comments for Russian viewers in Russia?
Niet.
All right, and then MVP for Demons, Katri Laine. First feelings after the game?
Tired. And disappointed, of course.
How did you see your own team? Who were, or maybe not who, but where were you good and where were you bad?
Maybe we lost the line of scrimmage, but... sorry, I'm so tired.
Well, Mika, can you fill in for Katri for this one? I know it's for athletes, it's pretty tiring to stay in the interviews sometimes, but Mika, any comments on that?
Yeah, of course, on the running, we were time to time, we had carries like 8, 10, 15 yards, but inconsistent. We were inconsistent. Sometimes we got 10-yard gain, then we were 5 yards back, so we were inconsistent today. That's the key.
Yeah, that's what we noticed too, that especially on the red zone, they really, really gathered the groups and made some big plays behind the line of scrimmage. Yeah. First, you forced you to try to pass the ball, and it's tight quarters there.
Yeah.
All right, but thank you and good luck for the rest of the season.
Thank
the
you.
Season and the playoffs are still coming.
Yeah, we hope so.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you for everybody, and good luck for all the teams in the rest of the season.